Welcome to the Higher Life Telecast. We have a blessed word in store for you, so stay tuned. Well, I am just blessed and excited to be able to come into your homes, your office, your car, or wherever you may be on this morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you may be in the world. We're starting a new series, and I just want to sit and talk to you and teach. And I believe that as you sit and listen to this teaching, stay consistent with it week after week, you're going to see new growth in your life. We're going to start the series, Abundant Supply, God being the abundant supplier. We're going to John 10th chapter in the 10th verse, and it reads, "The thief cometh not but to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly." I think for most of you, this is not new to your ears and hearing that I come to give life and to give it more abundantly. These are the very words of Jesus. But many are asking, and maybe you're asking, well, I know and I believe the word that Jesus came to give me abundant life, but I'm not experiencing. Where is this abundant life that God has called for? When you read that scripture in the Amplified version, it says, "The thief comes only in order to steal and kill and destroy. I am come that they may have and enjoy life and have it in abundance to the full till it overflows." These are the words in the Amplified version. It says the abundant life is an overflowing life. I want to tell you a story before we go a little bit further. I was raised in a Christian home and just wonderful, wonderful, good parents. My father, pastor, my mother, first lady of the church, and my father, just a great man of God. He really supplied and took care of his family. But there's one thing that I observed or experienced in growing up, and that's this, is that my father, he just always loved to buy secondhand things. He kept old cars around the house and kept fixing up old cars. Anytime there was new furniture, it was time for new furniture. It wasn't brand new. It was usually furniture that came from a secondhand store or some of his clothes that he brought that was secondhand clothes. Wonderful dad, wonderful mom, but I was just raised experiencing getting new stuff that was really used. And so I had a mindset as I grew up that I only deserve second best. I only deserve secondhand. I never realized as I came into salvation, I never realized and understood that God was interested in giving me as a believer his best. As a matter of fact, he gave me his best, starting with his son. So I had a mindset of just settling for second best. And that's what many people, and maybe you're going through, that you know the word says that you can live the abundant life. However, you feel undeserving of it, or you're used to a certain trend, a certain pattern, you'll get the second best. You'll get the used item. But I'm here to announce to you, you don't have to live that kind of life. That's not what God had for you, has in store for you. Now, when we hear the abundant life and we read the scriptures about the abundant life, the first thing that comes to our minds is money. But the abundant life is not just about money. It's about living a life of fullness and living in great victory. When Jesus Christ said, "I come to give you life, the God kind of life, and to give it to you abundantly," he's saying that everything that he's given you, he wants you to overflow in it, not just money, but in health and so much more. In order to really understand the abundant life, we want to go all the way back to the book of Genesis, the first chapter, just to understand the model that God has set and established for the believer and is established in the book of beginnings. I want you to really listen very closely. God is shifting your thinking and your confession into terms of abundance and fullness in every part of your life, because you're about to come into something greater, something better. You're about to overflow with the blessings and the promises of God. If you can change your perception like I did, I had a perception that I only deserve second best and second handed. But when I changed my perception, it changed my confession. And when it changed my confession, it changed my reception. So if you can change your perception, and it will impact your confession, and you can change your reception. So God wants you to receive from him an abundance, not just things, but whatever he wants you to have spiritually and naturally, he wants you to have it in abundance. Let's go to the Old Testament as we move further in this journey, this Bible study journey. Let's go to the Old Testament, to Genesis, the first chapter. Are you ready? Just to see the mindset of God, to see how God talks. What's God's language? Does God talk in language of that'll do, that's just enough, a little itty bitty for you and a little tiny bit for this one and for that one, I can't afford it? What's the language of God? In order for you to really adapt and receive and change your perception so it can impact your confession, so it will then in turn impact your reception, you got to understand the language of God. You are in God and God is on the inside of you. So let's go back to the book of the beginnings and let's see how God did things, how God created things. Because when you understand how God created things, how God fixed things, how God restored things, how God renovated things, you'll understand God's thinking, not only about things and about the creation beyond you or the animals, the animal kingdom, and what happened in the air and underground, but what is happening, what's happening in your life. So let's go to Genesis. First chapter says, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Now, in this Genesis, in the book of Genesis, the first chapter and the second verse, we see a very chaotic situation here. The earth was dark. There was a flood. It was formless, but yet the Spirit of God was moving upon the face of the waters. That kind of depicts many people's lives and many people's situation. It may even reflect your situation. There's some things that's out of order. There may be some things that's chaotic in your life that needs to be fixed and addressed. But there's hope. There's hope for you that the Bible says that the Spirit of God was there in the midst of chaos. The Spirit of God was there. The Spirit of God is there right now in the room, in your life, to be able to address things. And now God is faced with this awesome responsibility to bring change and to bring renovation.
Thank you for your consistent support of the Higher Life Telecast. We have some exciting news for you. You can now partner with Dr. Aretha Wilson as she continues to impact millions around the world through the gospel of Jesus Christ. For a seed of only $49 or more, you can receive your victory package, which includes Dr. Aretha Wilson's latest book release, Confessions of the Faithful, along with a great prayer tool and guidebook, Answered Prayers from A to Z, as well as a prophetic instrumental CD birthed out of worship. Upgrade to the Victory Premium Package for a seed of $79 or more, which also includes the audio version of the revelatory word, What's the Blood Got to Do with It?, and one of Dr. Aretha Wilson's prophetic declaration magnets. God has a blessing just for you. Become a partner with Aretha Wilson Ministries today at www.drarethawilson.com/partner. Or mail checks or money orders to Aretha Wilson Ministries, P.O. Box 211, St. Albans, New York, 11412, and make payable to Ra.
Now let's move forward in the story. God is renovating. He's fixing this chaos. The Spirit of God is there. And now he's about to bring change, renovate the earth, restore it. Bring the animal kingdom and all the creation, all the creatures, he's about to bring them now onto the scene. And let's move a little further. We're going to skip a few verses. Again, understand, I want you to understand and see the mind and the language of God at creation and at restoration and renovation in the beginning. The Bible says, and God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters. So you see, there's a division. Now God is bringing to surface the land and dividing the water from the land. And now we skip over to the 14th verse. It says, and God said, let there be lights. Listen very carefully. In the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years. So here you now, you see God creating the planet, the planets and the lights, and he's establishing the times and the seasons. Now we move forward. He gives the light to govern by day, and rather he gives the moon to govern by night. He gives the sun, he assigns the sun to govern by day. Now let's go over to the 20th verse. Now God's ready to bring creatures on the earth. And how does he do it? What does he say? And God said, let the waters bring forth abundantly. That's right. Let the waters bring forth abundantly. He didn't say, let the waters bring a few fish. He said abundantly. That word in the Old Testament, abundantly, actually means a swarm of fish, a swarm of sea creatures. He said, come forth abundantly. So you see that when Jesus said in John 10 and 10, that's that God comes to give you life, that Jesus comes to give you life, and that more abundantly. That wasn't the first time God thought about giving you or me abundant life. God thinks and speaks in terms of abundance all the way back to the book of beginnings in Genesis, the first chapter. So you see him creating in the magnitude of abundance. Let's go on. And the Bible says, and God created the whales, great whales, and every living creature that moveth, which he waters, which the waters brought forth abundantly. Here's that word abundant again. So how does God talk? How does God think? He thinks and speaks in terms of abundance. So we have to get out of our minds, that God just want to do a little something, just touch you right here, just a little bit, just distribute something a little bit right here and there. No, whatever God wants to do for you, he plans to do it in terms of abundance. Let's read on. And God blessed him, saying, be fruitful and multiply and fill the waters. He said, look, listen to that word. Be fruitful and multiply. He didn't say, be fruitful and just bring forth another fish and just bring forth another plant, another flower. He said, multiply. So when God wants to see things coming to fruition, he wants it to come to fruition in terms of big and grand and large and huge and a whole lot, a swarm of things. Not just add one plus one, multiply. Now listen to this. Again, we're talking about the language of God. In order for you to really experience the abundant life, you have to own and believe that the same God that spoke the earth into existence and created all the things to inhabit the earth, he created it and he wanted it in abundance. And if he wanted it for the earth, he wants it for you. For you. Yes, for you. And it says, and he said, and fill the waters in the seas and let the fowl multiply in the earth. Let the fowl multiply in the earth. So he intended for the birds, and he even said, birds, I want you to multiply in the air. You see the language? I want you to understand so that you, when, as we begin to walk and move into the abundant life and understand God as a divine abundant supplier, you understand that this is the will of God. This is not just hype. This is not just another prosperity message. This is how our God thinks, speaks, lives, blesses, gives, creates, restores, renovate, and so much more. My God, I'm so excited when I think about it, when I think about how God speaks and thinks and blesses and increases. And even when God created man, look at Genesis 1 and 28. Now, you've heard it before, you've read it before. The Bible says that God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male and female created he them. And what does God say to Adam and Eve? He says, and God blessed them, and God said unto them, be lack, be full of lack. Don't have anything. Just barely make it. Just do the best you can. No, he doesn't say that. What God said to mankind, he said, be fruitful and multiply. So you see the language of God? See the language of God? He thinks, speaks, blesses, assigns, mandates in terms of multiplicity. He says, be fruitful and multiply. Replenish the earth. Subdue it. Have dominion. He didn't just say, just do a little something, just do a little work. He even used the words like dominion. Those are words of enlargement. He says, have dominion. Look at the words he used. He didn't just say, take care of this over here. He said, have dominion. And the same God that spoke to Adam and Eve is speaking to us. He says, have dominion, which means he doesn't plan for you just to have a little something over here, be in the corner in a shed somewhere, take care of that little room, take care of a little shoe, take care of this, and you know, just drive out the spiders and fan the flies. No, have dominion over great things. God intends to not only enlarge you, but put you over great things. Do you see it? I'm getting excited. You know, my bishop told me the other day, just lower your voice. So I don't want to try to preach. I want to talk to you. I want to impact your life with the word of God. I feel that change is taking place right now. I won't be able to finish this series in this one setting. So you have to tune in every week. Your life is going to change, expand, and grow. Let me continue. Here, the Bible says, and he said, have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. Now, look, listen to this revelation. Now, here, we already read in Genesis 1 and 20 and 21 and 22, we saw the language of God. And the Bible says he told the fish to come forth abundantly. He told the fowls to come forth abundantly. He told the fish, the fowls, the animal kingdom to be fruitful, to multiply, to fill the waters, and to multiply the earth. So look at this now. So God already, before he put man there, he created the animal king and the creatures in massive, massive numbers. And then he tells Adam and Eve, I want you to have dominion over this massive, massive number of species in the land and in the sea. So God, if you're going to put all this into the hands of Adam and all this into the hands of mankind, then you must surely, you're going to equip mankind with a massive amount of ability and capability to be able to govern it. Do you see that? So God's not going to not only put great things into your hands and then give you a minimal amount of ability and capacity to rule and govern and keep it subject and grow it. He's going to equip you with great things. This is what Jesus was talking about when he said, I come to give you life, Zoe life, God kind of life, and that life more abundantly. Let me give you this definition. I think I'm running out of time, and so you have to tune in next week. Here it is. Look at this word, that the definition of abundant. When Jesus said abundant, it means exceeding abundantly. It means very highly, beyond measure, more than superfluous. Lewis, exceeding some number or measure or rank, over and above, more than what is necessary. So God's not just trying to give you, here, this is just what's necessary, what's good for today. God is saying, I give you more than what you can even imagine. Not exceedingly abundantly, but exceeding abundantly. That's the kind of life and thinking and language that God speaks in. That's just one Old Testament model. And God has not changed his mind, although man fell. God hasn't changed his mind. We're now in Christ. We've been born again. And you weren't born again into a lesser quality of life. You've been born again to the higher life. And God said, he doesn't merely intend for you to exist and live from paycheck to paycheck and live sick and live depleted and in deficiency. God said, it's time that you accept and understand the principle of living the abundant life and the mandate and the will of God. And as you change your perception, it's going to impact your confession. And as it impacts your confession, it's going to impact your reception. It's your time to begin to live the abundant life that Jesus said. Well, I'm out of time today. We're going to break. I have some very important announcements to share with you, and they want to come back and pray with you. I trust you will be blessed. Stay tuned. I'm just going to spend the next few weeks just coming into your living room and just talking to you, because I have a great burden, a great passion to impact your life with the Word of God so you can begin to experience the abundant life and understand your Father as a divine, abundant supplier. So stay tuned. I'll be right back so I can pray for you. So stay tuned.